The context is if by agreeing with China not to repair BRP Sierra Madre and only agree to supplies for water and food, according to Carpio, kung lumubog yun, nawala na tayo. This is his exact quote. Papasok ang China. Parang ibinigay niya ang Ayungin Shoal sa China.
You know, Karen, if you read the one of the papers today has an account that despite what President Duterte allegedly said, we continued up to Lorenzana. He was still with President PRRD, I think. Up to the end, in fact, the paper reports that they were inside the resupply vessel and they brought planks, they brought equipment to refurbish. So this is what I'm saying. This is foreign affairs. You sometimes you say something and then the lawyers will say, okay, that's it. But you can do something else. The term being used is discarte. Mm-hmm. Discarte, because we are not a strong nation. We have to face it. So I find this is not productive to go back. What we should do is to go forward. We have an award. President Duterte has said before the UN that we have this award. Okay. President Marcos is now in the office. He has the mandate of the people. He doesn't believe in status quo. So, but you know, I there's a one big difference, Karen. During the time when we filed the arbitral award, nobody was on our side. Okay, then we got the award. When we got the award, I met with Secretary Ochoa and then incoming Secretary Yasay, and they asked, please don't say anything. Kasi January 30, pumasok si PRRD. And so we did not do anything. And then the award came in, and the president, PRRD, was very careful. So what he did was I think he just said, okay, let's have peace, let's have the status quo. Now we have so many allies. Now, for example, when we filed the case, nobody from the U.S. said, this is the U.S. defense treaty is ironclad. Now we have the president of the United States. Kaya mas matapang ng konti ngayon na presidente natin. So wag na natin halungkatin ang kasi nung time ni President Duterte, nung time ni President Aquino, wala tayo noon. I also hear that President Duterte said, eh kung ganun na, padala nyo nga ang 7th Fleet sa Ayungin, hindi wala, tapos na. So I think my point is, let us be careful na we only have one president, we only have one foreign policy. Tama naman ang ginagawa ni President Marcos.
Yeah.
Tama naman. Now, ang nakaraan, wag na natin. You know, ang ano diyan, Karen, every president has a time, every president has a mandate. We vote for different presidents. Sometimes a presidente mo nanalo, sometimes tatalo. We serve only once. But unti-unti, nasusulong ba ang interest natin? Yun ang punto ko.
Oo. Tama po kayo doon. Now, the president is the chief architect of foreign policy. But what's difficult is if the foreign policy when it comes to the West Philippine Sea is dependent on one leader. I mean, clearly, China is playing the long game, right? They don't change their foreign policy. So during the time of former President Duterte, even if the arbitral award was there, some have said he didn't maximize the arbitral award, right? So,
yes.
Yeah, so that's a criticism on that part. With this particular president, he holds on the arbitral award, reaffirms it, but some have criticized him that he's pivoting way towards the U.S. So it's that changing foreign policy that the Philippines is, I would have to say it's quite, this is where it's precarious because where we are with the West Philippine Sea depends on the leader. And it shouldn't be the case. It shouldn't be the case, right?
Well, Karen, we have to live with the fact that we are a democracy, unlike China. That's why they can afford only one leader. Xi Jinping will outlive all of us. They have only one policy. So nakita ko yan. Pag sinabi ng hepe ng China na ganitong sasabihin, lahat susunod. Now, that's ideal in one sense, but it's not also ideal in a democracy. So we have to live with the fact that we have had three presidents already. Ulitin ko, nag-umpisa si President Aquino, mabuti na lang, nag-arbitration tayo. Kasi kung, isipin mo Karen, ha? Kung walang arbitration, there's nobody who will say what is right. So ang what we achieved during the Aquino administration is to have clarity. Na klaro na, okay, that's why we have more allies today, I think. Now, nung nanalo si PRRD, hindi pa rin clear ang pivot ng US. They were not saying ironclad at the time. That's why hindi mo ma blame ang mama na hinay-hinay. But it takes time. So 6 years after, you have a new president. Now we have an ironclad commitment from President Biden. So we can be a little bit more aggressive. If viewed from that point of view, we are making strides. Although we're a very small country. That's the way I look at it.
Okay, so let's move on to Scarborough Shoal. As of today, it's said that within the shoal, there are two Chinese ships that are just stationed inside the shoal. Okay, and the arbitral ruling was clear that Scarborough Shoal is a common fishing ground for the Philippines, China, and Japan. And yet the Philippines isn't fishing inside Scarborough Shoal. How do we move forward?
That's the problem of enforcement. But I will stress, were it not for the arbitral award, then wala tayong panghahawakan na tayo ay may right to fish, okay? Having said that, how do we enforce it? Now, diskarte na naman ng Pilipino. We have the BFAR, we have, but may problema doon ng konti. How do you, because the so large, the fishing ground is so large, that hindi mo mabantayan always. So that's going to be a continuing problem of enforcement. But ang sabi ko naman, ang nakakalimutan ng mga Pilipino, ang laki ng ginastos natin to get the award. But unfortunately, it's only the president who can tell the Filipino people how much we spent. Now, ang laki ng panalo natin, Karen, sa environment, for example, mischief reef, gumawa ang China ng artificial island doon, gumawa ng military emplacement. Klarong-klaro, sinabi ng arbitral award, mali ang China doon, mali. So what we need to do, konti na lang hirap, konti na lang ebidensya, we should get a large award there. Doon dapat.
From who? From where? That's
China.
Interesting.
From
yeah.
China.
Okay.
Kasi that's the award. That's the award.
But China won't recognize that.
Yes,
China
but,
does not recognize the award.
Yes, they do not recognize the award. But if we file another case, of course, they expectedly, they will not join. But the UNCLOS provides that provided we have grounds, kahit hindi mag-participate ang other party. That's what happened to our arbitration. So, we get a big award, kung ilang billion ang damage natin sa mischief reef, sa mga fishing, ganon, etc. Then, may panghawakan tayo. Then we enforce it through UNCLOS sa assets ng China. Wag naman sa Pilipinas, magulo. You go to New York, you go to wherever they have assets. Now, diskarte na naman yan. At that point in time, kung manalo tayo, then maybe China will soften. I don't know. But rather than tayo mga Pilipino mag-away, yun ang punto ko, Karen. So if the Senate is minded, dapat instead of investigating or the House investigating, they should just help the president and find out how much did we spend, for example, to get the award. What happens to the award now? Why are we not filing a case to get China to pay for the environmental damage? Yun, klaro yun, walang awa yun.
So,
rather than going back, and I don't like this, Karen, nag-aaway tayo. Pilipino tayo lahat eh.
Tama, tama. So you believe that moving forward, that's one thing this administration can do. Because yes, it would be a legacy for the Marcos administration. Do you recommend, because you have former, the late President Aquino remembered for actually supporting the filing of this case, right? It has to be the state that files the case, not an individual. So do you believe that this administration should file the case, another case for environmental damages?
Yes. Precisely, Karen. Noong bandang October last year, Secretary Lemulia already called me and attorney the Ramon Magsaysay awardee, the UP. He called us and then he announced that he's studying, he formed a study group because he was committed to file. He said he had the ear of the president. And I checked with Secretary Teodoro and the executive secretary. They said it is true that he has the mandate. Now, they brought in the Solicitor General. Kasi ang mungkahi ko, Karen, malaki ang gastos natin nung last time. Kasi may
foreign... Malaki. Sir, would you be able to give me just an estimate?
Well, ang estimate, ang alam ko, Karen, ang binayad ko kay sa law office ni Reichler is in US dollars, no? And then, ang
like roughly how much?
No,
like $10 million?
Dalawang beses yun, tapos may other gastos pa tayo. Ngayon, sabihin ko, malapit sa 1 billion pesos.
Okay, Just to, I get you. It's everything included, no? Filing the case, the money needed actually to fuel the case, etc. So okay.
Yeah, that's just the direct cost, Karen. Yung binayad natin sa Marikano, binayad natin na filing fee, at saka yung binayad natin sa mga experts natin. Wala pa yung mga ginastos sa mga Pilipino. Kunwari, pupunta kami sa Hague. That's the direct cost. So it will be more than that. No, but that's for the president to tell the Filipino people. That is what the Senate should do to us. Parang ako, Karen, naghihinayang ako kasi ang laki ng ginastos natin. Now, the opportunity now, I can tell you, as I have been telling people, kayang-kaya ng office of the Solicitor General. Kayang-kaya. So we will spend only for the experts. Kaya kung magkaso tayo, siyempre ang mga Pilipino ay katuwang natin, mga scientists, mga Filipino lawyers. But we should get also credible foreign experts. Kasi we are before a court. Kung Pilipino lahat ang tisigo natin, hindi ka panipaniwala. Now we will have to spend a little bit, upgrade the evidence. But ang sinabi ng arbitral award ay, may kasalanan malaki ang China sa environmental degradation, sa mischief reef. Hindi man natin mabawi ang mischief reef, magbayad man kayo.
Very good points. Now, just to close, I wanted to ask you about exploring the reed bank. You have countries like Malaysia that are already doing their own exploration. Where do you stand on that? During the time of former President Duterte, there was a moratorium on the exploration.
Yes, I understand. They had a moratorium because it natatakot ang CPRRT. But now, we have the arbitral award. It says clearly tayong may-ari ng reed bank. We can reopen it. Now, may mga mungkay na sasamahan daw tayo ng merkano dyan. Sabi ko, sinabi, we don't need their allies kasi if we send our Filipino naval ships there to accompany our scientific ships, kung bubumbahin man sila ng China, we have the mutual defense treaty.
The problem is China, it's not as simplistic as that. What China is doing is provocations in the gray zone. So it doesn't activate the mutual defense treaty.
Well, yes. That's why they are playing this game that they will do water cannons. Ang problema lang, Karen, is the arbitral award said that and specifically with Ayungin Shoal, may isang paragraph lang out of 514 pages, kahaba ng ng decision. Isang paragraph lang sinabi ang operation ng China at saka Chinese Navy and the Chinese militia, itong mga paramilitary vessels nila. Isa military operation, kaya wala sa jurisdiction. So we have to live with that. Now, there are ways to help ourselves there. We have been playing cat and mouse with them. Kaya lang,
yes.
We saw recently three of our servicemen were injured. So we have to help the president think about now. Kaya ang ako bilang abogado, ang siyempre ang reaction ko is to file a case. But I'm not saying that filing a case is the only remedy. We have the president should have a full menu, military, diplomatic, lahat yan ay tulong-tulong. Ang tanong ko ngayon, bakit wala na tayong legal option? Yung kasi matagal ka rin when we filed the case, when I got the order from the president, it took almost 1 year to prepare. And then when we filed the case, 1 year to magtagisan pa ng papel. And then 1 year to tatlong taon. Now, what I am afraid of is maabutan tayo ng midterm elections.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah.
So in effect, you are recommending President Marcos Jr. to already decide and yes. act on filing another case.
Yes. Kasi
environmental damages. Kumbaga, do it now.
Now, kasi pag umabot na ang midterm election, but even now, I can feel that medyo konting may politika na eh. Now, the beauty nung time ni Pinoy, wala pang nakakaalam. So we were quite free to do our thing. Now, it's now in the open. Maraming sumasakay. So I think the president should now tell the Filipino people, namuhuna ng Pilipinas, ganito ang ginastos natin, sayang naman, we have to follow up in the environment. Sa environment lang. Now, ang military, we have allies now. We have the United States, we have Great Britain, we have Japan. So it's a holistic, buong solusyon.
Yeah.
Rather than mag-away-away tayo.
Very interesting today. Thank you so much. I do hope to have you back on Head Start, former Solicitor General Francis Ardeleza. We can talk about this more at length. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.